start. Aloha, I'm Joshua Cooper. I'm the executive director of the Hawaii Institute for Human Rights and the Good Group. And I'm also a lecturer at the University of Hawaii, as well as a coordinator for the International Human Rights and Law Program at the University of the District of Columbia, known as Human Rights on the Hill.
And let me ask you one question. I have two questions. What is your purpose here in Geneva, especially with the ADL delegates?
So we're here at the 29th session of the UN Human Rights Council. It's the highest body at the United Nations that focuses on human rights promotion and protection. And what we're doing here at the 29th session predominantly is focusing on the final element of the Universal Periodic Review. You can see behind me the same chair where in January over 100 people from Laos came to make sure that their voice was heard at the Universal Periodic Review. What'll happen at the 29th session is that the UPR on Laos, the 196 recommendations, will be adopted. So we came this week to first and foremost meet with governments and ensure that the governments of the world know that the situation has actually gotten worse and the human rights violations have increased inside Laos. So to give them an accurate picture of the genuine situation that people on the ground face inside the nation of Laos. So that's what we're doing here this week. But while we're also here for this important meeting, we also make the most of the experience. And what we've done is we've made sure that we've begun the next phase of our human rights work. So at the Human Rights Council, there's a couple of things that can be done. First thing is you can meet with the special procedures. You can meet with the special procedures of the Human Rights Councils focusing on various themes. So what we did was we actually made sure that we met with the Special Rapporteur on Cultural Rights, and we made sure there was no more wondering about what was going on inside Laos, but to make sure they knew exactly why things were being done and what was happening. So what we did was we met with the Special Rapporteur on Cultural Rights to give the latest information of what's been taking place in the last couple of months and to note the urgency of the genuine problems that the people face due to a corrupt regime. So we've been working on that. We've also, though, been attending other sessions, such as the resolution writing. We know climate change is very important in Laos, so we've been focusing on the resolution on human rights and climate change, and also looking at the new Sustainable Development Goals, which will be adopted in September, because there'll be 17 Sustainable Development Goals, which Laos will have to explain and share how it's meeting those goals, as well as the 169 targets. So that was the focus of the conversation yesterday.
Thank you. Now I give the floor to the World Association for the School as an instrument of peace.
Mr. Vice President, we change the independent expert on human rights and international solidarity on draft declaration on the rights of people and individuals on international solidarity. It will also be relevant for the upcoming adoption of the UN Sustainable Development Goals, especially low-up mechanism. We can see that beyond of declaration of to address challenges in many communities and countries, especially in the Asia-Pacific region of the United Nations. Regarding Article 2, Paragraph C, is extremely relevant regarding permanent sovereignty of our natural wealth and resources for social development. This must be guiding principle for Laos and is a common concern for humanity. We ask for all members of the UNHRC Council to consider in this UPR adoption of Laos. The people have no right to choose their government or to change the government. There is no free election. There is no separation of power. We also believe Article 3, Paragraph A, highlighting preventive solidarity essential. The international, the intergenerational approach is valuable. We participate in the UN Human Rights Council and UPR in the spirit of Article 5, that human rights is birthright and everyone shall operate together. We believe if the 196 recommendations are accepted, we can create a roadmap for human rights in our homeland Laos.
Sorry, time's up. Next, I give the floor to the International Muslim Women's Union.
Hello, I'm Marcus Wiese. I'm from the Alliance for Democracy in Laos. I make the public work and the press work for the Alliance for Democracy. I also make the website work, Facebook work for the Alliance for Democracy, all the public work. That means supporting and organize events for the Alliance for Democracy in Laos in relation with human rights, democratization and so on. Here we are at the 29th session of the Human Rights Council. It's a very, very important session because human rights runs more and more into the focus of the world. Human rights are much more important than the last years, and especially Laos goes into the focus of the international community. After the impact with Sombat Somphone, after the incident, the international organizations and the United Nations know what's going on in Laos. They want to look what's going on there, and they see that the situation in Laos goes much worse than the last years. This is our work, how to submit here the human rights bodies here in Geneva, all the messages from Laos, all the news from Laos. And we need an interactive dialogue between the Lao government today, the CSO NGOs, and the UN human rights bodies to look for solutions for the Lao problems